In this video, I'll take you through the setup of this Vandal-proof dome IP camera by linking it up to a computer over a local area network without using an NVR, even though you can still connect it through an NVR. If you look around it, it is cableless, but it is not a wireless camera. It is indeed a wired camera. I'll be using this PoE switch in the setup since the camera is a PoE IP camera. Because we'll be linking the camera to a computer, we'll need a router. So this is the router that we'll be using in the setup. I must mention that you don't necessarily need internet service on this router. Or in other words, internet is not a requirement to be able to link any IP camera to a computer over a local area network. Here are already terminated network cables to be used in connecting the various devices in this setup. Because the connection ports of this camera are housed within the camera itself, so we'll begin by opening up the camera through the screws around it. So with the help of a provided Allen key, we'll loosen the screws. So I'll just lift up the Vandal-proof housing now. This is what remains after opening the Vandal-proof housing. This is where the ports for connecting cables into the camera are located. Very paramount among the connection ports here is the Ethernet connection port, which is a power over Ethernet or a PoE port, through which you can both power this camera using a network cable and as well receive video from this same port through the same network cable. The rest of the ports here are for secondary functions and controls. So in this video, we'll be utilizing only the Ethernet connection port to both power and receive video from this camera. This is the point through which all cables from this camera need to be passed through by perforating the weather boot to make way for the cable passage. Here is my first network cable I will use to connect the camera to my PoE switch. So I'll pass it and plug it into the Ethernet port. So this connection will both carry video from the camera and at the same time supply power to the camera. This other end of the network cable will be plugged into the PoE switch. So I'll just plug it into any of the PoE ports on the PoE switch. You can see that the camera is powered on and there is interaction between the camera and the PoE switch, as indicated by the blinking LED lights. Because we are going to be viewing this camera on a computer, we will connect the PoE switch to a router. So with the help of this network cable, I'll plug one end into the uplink port of the PoE switch and plug into any LAN port on the router. I'll use this network cable to connect the computer to the router. So I'll plug this end into a LAN port on the router and this other end goes into the computer. So this is the setup so far. The camera is connected to the PoE switch and an uplink port on the PoE switch has been connected to a LAN port on the router. And as well, the computer has also been connected to a LAN port on the router, which I did using the yellow colored cable as you can see. So let's now see how the setup is done on the computer. This is the desktop of my computer and here is a VMS I have already installed through which we would view the camera. I have shared a link to where you can download this VMS. That is if you are using a JoeVision camera. If not, you need to visit the website of your brand of camera for their version of VMS. So I'll go ahead and launch my VMS. I'll input my password. I created this username and password on this particular software, so you need to do as well. And then you log in. This is the home page of the software. We will open the device management by clicking here. You will have to come down here and click on search devices. The search is ongoing. You can see a device that is listed here, and this is the camera. So you can double click the camera to add it up to the software. The status here is indicating that the device is online. So we can go back to the home page and go to video preview. You can see IPC 1-on-1, meaning that there is a device online that we can preview. So we'll click here to have a drop down of the specific device. Double click at it to load the video preview. And there you have the video. From this point, the rest is just operational. You can carry out the various settings on the camera. Please send me your comments and feedbacks about this video. But please remember to subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet subscribed. And also give this video a thumbs up. Thank you once again for watching. See you in the next video.